volume of cylinder. Okay, so first problem is the thickness of a hollow wooden cylinder is 2 cm. It is 35 cm long and its inner radius is 12 cm. Find the volume of the wood required to make the cylinder. Okay, we have to find out volume. Assuming it is open either end. Okay, means one side it is open. Here this is only given, information is given. Okay, if it is open from both the sides, we cannot find out volume. Okay, so this we have to assume just. Okay, so now the thickness of a hollow wooden cylinder is 2 cm. Thickness is given. Okay, hollow cylinder. How we find out thickness of hollow cylinder? Thickness of hollow wooden cylinder is given 2 cm. 2 cm. Okay, thickness we have to find out. Thickness means what? External radius. External radius we denote by capital R minus small r is equal to 2 cm. Okay, so this is given, R minus, capital R minus small r is equal to 2 cm. It is 35 cm long. 35 cm long. Okay, length is given, means that is the height of the cylinder, 35 cm. And its inner radius is given 12 cm. Okay, inner radius means what? Small r is equal to 12 cm. Inner radius is given 12 cm. Okay, so we have to find the volume of the wood required to make the cylinder. Okay, how to find out volume of hollow cylinder? Volume of hollow cylinder is equals to pi capital R square minus small r square into h. Okay, this formula we are going to use, but we need to see all the values are given or not, or we need to find out some unknown values. See here, pi value we can put 22/7. R is given, small r, inner radius is given, and height is given, but capital R is not given. So that we need to find out. Without this, we cannot find out volume. Okay. So how we'll find out? This is here. Thickness is given, R minus capital R minus small r is equal to 2 cm. So here we can put, here inner radius is given 12 cm. So that we can put here. So that I'm taking now here, R minus 12 is equal to 2. So R equals to what? 2 plus 12 is 14 cm. So we have R also. Capital R we have, then small r we have, then height we have, pi we can put. Okay. So now easily we can find out volume. So now here I am going to write here 22/7 multiply by R means what? 14 square minus small r is 12 square into height is, what is the height? 35 cm³. Okay, because this is volume, it will come in its units cube. Okay, so now here we can do here 7 ones are 7, 7 5s are 35, 22 5s are 110 multiply by 14 square is, here you can use a square minus b square also, but here this answer easily we can find out. If numbers are big, then we can use a square minus b square is equal to a plus b, a minus b. For 14 square is 196 minus 12 square is 144 centimeter cube. So 110 multiply by 6 minus 4 is 2 and 9 minus 4 is 5, 52 centimeter cube. So 110 into 52 will be 5720 centimeter cube. Understood? So this is the volume of that. They are asking for volume of wood. Okay. So this is our final answer. Understood? So this is example of hollow cylinder. Here it is given directly, so not necessary to think much on that. So what we have done, thickness was given, inner radius was given. With the help of that, we have to find out external radius, because without that we cannot find out volume of hollow cylinder. So all those values we have to put here. When you will do your calculations, that time you will get answer 5720 centimeter cube. Okay, so this was the first problem. Understood? Now here we will take second problem. We will see here, the thickness of a metallic tube is 1 cm and the inner diameter of the tube is 12 centimeter. Okay, thickness is given 1 centimeter and inner diameter is given 12 centimeter. Find the weight of 1 meter long tube. Weight of 1 meter long tube. If the density of the metal be 7.8 gram per centimeter square. Okay, so now first I am going to mention here which things are given. Okay, the thickness of a metallic tube is 1 centimeter. Thickness is given. Thickness of metallic pipe, metallic tube is equal to 1 centimeter. Thickness is given. Okay, this is hollow cylinder because here metallic tube means you will get 2 radius. So from that thickness is given 1 centimeter and inner diameter is equals to what is inner diameter is given. Inner diameter of the tube is 12 centimeter. So inner radius we can find out from this. Inner radius we denote by small r. So 12 by 2 centimeter, that is 6 centimeter. Inner radius you got. Okay. Now the weight tube is 12 centimeter. Find the weight of 1 meter long tube. So here what is given? 1 meter height. Height is equal to 1 meter. 1 meter is equal to 100. Centimeter. We need to convert meter into centimeter because all other units dimensions are given in centimeter. Okay. So now we have height, we have inner radius, and we have to find out volume. Okay. Volume of the metallic tube. Okay. So volume of metallic tube is equals to pi in brackets capital R square minus small r square into h. But here we don't have capital R, means external radius we don't have, but we can find out that external radius, okay, because thickness is given. So thickness is equals to R minus small r is equal to 1 centimeter. Small r is given 6 centimeter, so R minus 6 is equal to 1, so capital R is equals to 7 centimeter. Okay, so this we have, then height we have, small radius we have. Okay, so we can find out easily now volume of the metallic tube. So volume is equals to pi r square minus small r square into h. Okay. So pi we will put here 22 by 7 multiply by r 7 square minus small r is 6 square into height is 100. Okay. Unit cube. So centimeter cube. Okay. Unit we have to write carefully. So now 22 by 7, 7 square is 49. 7 square or 7 plus 6, 7 square is 49 minus 6 square is 36 into 100 centimeter cube. So 22 by 7 multiply by 49 minus 36. 9 minus 6 is 3, 4 minus 3 is 1 multiply by 100 centimeter cube. Okay. So this is the volume of metallic tube. Now what they are asking? Find the weight of 1 meter long tube if the density of the metal be 7.8 grams is given. Density is given. What is density? 7.8 gram per centimeter cube. That density is given. And we have to find out weight. Okay. So you know that one formula, weight. Weight is equals to volume multiplied by density. Volume multiplied by density. Okay, so we have to, they are asking weight, and weight is equals to volume multiplied by density. Volume we have, that is this, you can find out final answer also, or as it is you can keep here because our question is this. Okay, so volume, without this we cannot find out weight. So volume and density they have given us directly. So now weight is equals to 22 by 7 multiplied by 13 multiplied by 100, and density is given 7.8 gram. Okay, this is gram per centimeter cube. So this answer will get in grams. Okay, so what is the answer you will get after calculation? 31,868.57. Okay, grams. These calculations when you will do, that time will get answer 31,868.57 grams. But this is, we need to convert into kilogram. Generally we give this such type of answers in kilogram. This is also correct answer, but if I want to convert into kilogram, what I will do? I need to divide by 1000. 68.57 divided by 1000. Okay, 1000 means this decimal point will shift 3 digits forward. So 1, 2, 3. So 31.868 57 kilograms. Okay, see here carefully once again what was given. The thickness was given. With the help of thickness and inner radius, we have to find out external radius. Okay, once you will get external radius, we have to find out volume. Here we have taken volume of hollow cylinder because this is metallic pipe. Here in the question it is not given this is a hollow cylinder, that we have to decide. Okay, so this is metallic tube, metallic pipe, any such type of example will come, then we have to use hollow cylinder. So that formula we have taken. So the values which we have, that they have given us, that values we have to put in the formula and you will get volume. Okay, finally we have to find out weight. So weight is equal to volume into density. You have learned this is in science. Okay, volume multiplied by density. So for that, here we have to find out volume. Okay, so volume you will put multiplied by density, but that is in grams. Okay, so final answer will get in grams. Here I have not shown you each and every calculations because it will take time. You can do it. So 31,868.57 grams that I need to convert into kilograms. So we have to divide by 1000. So final answer will get 31.86 kilograms. Okay, thank you.